Hey everyone, today I'm talking about Eddie Van Halen. Who else should I be talking about, right? I got his guitar here, it's sounding good. I want to let you know about an interview that I read on the weekend. I was reading an old guitar magazine called Guitar for the Practicing Musician. Maybe some of you remember that one, some of you graybeard guys like me. Anyway, they were supporting, I think Van Halen was supporting the OU812 album, also known as the OU Bought 12 because so many people bought it. Yeah, in that interview, the interviewer asked him a really interesting question. It was, when did you find your individual voice on the instrument? I figured, oh, before I read the answer, Eddie's probably going to say something like tapping. You know, think of like... I mean, who was doing that, right? Nobody really at that time. And then I thought, well, maybe it's going to be his picking. That kind of hummingbird-style picking. And then I thought, what else could it be? I don't know. Maybe the way Eddie uses like pick harmonics, his pick scrapes. I mean, there's probably 8 million pick scrapes on Van Halen 1. But it turns out, no, none of those answers would be true. In the interview, Eddie mentions that the use of his pinky actually is how he found his style, the reachy, stretchy kind of stuff. And he mentions that his brother Al kind of pushed him to get that happening on the guitar, because I guess he was kind of doing the three-finger Clapton thing, all that kind of stuff. And I guess that playing with the pinky thing kind of broke him out of those patterns, you know, the pentatonic patterns everyone plays with. Nothing wrong with that, but I mean, when you're trying to break out of a mold, you kind of want to push further. Anyway, I'll put up the excerpt from the interview. You can check it out. So I found Eddie's answer to the question quite interesting, and I thought, well, why don't I make a video about some of Eddie's stretchy stuff? I know I've done some of that stuff before, but these are new ones. I don't think I've shown anybody. And I thought, yeah, why don't I give you a rundown on what Eddie considered to be his uniqueness in his playing. So the first one is a symmetrical riff, or symmetrical-like riff, that Eddie would use quite often in songs like Girl Gone Bad, you hear it in Eruption and other places. This is at the end of a song called Pound Cake. And Pound Cake, if you crank up the ending, the very end of the song, I put the time in, if you look at the tab at my website, you got to go to my website to get the tab, by the way. It'll have the time there, but it's right at the fade out. So the song's kind of fading out. And if you just crank it up, you can hear this riff happen. So I'll show you how to play that, and then I'll have a couple more for you after that. So that's how you play that stretchy riff at the end of Pound Cake. Very challenging, but definitely worth putting some time into it to get it down. If you're enjoying the content that I'm putting out right now, then please send me a donation on PayPal. Any amount, doesn't really matter. The address is sachetellus.net. And also, if you'd like to get the tab for this lesson, click on the link in the description. It'll lead you right to my official website, and you'll get the tab for this and many other lessons that I've put up over the years. Anyway, I'm going to move on to the next two things that I'm going to show you, Eddie riffs that are kind of using that pinky and that sort of wide stretch thing. And the next one up will be from a song called So This Is Love off of the album Fair Warning. Here it is. Thank you. love that solo. Very quirky, very interesting playing from Eddie. Very tough to get that timing because he had this really interesting sense of time. Him and his brother were like joined at the brain somehow, you know, the mind meld. So yeah, hopefully you get something out of that one. And now I'm going to show you a little excerpt from the solo Live Without a Net. And it's another part that Eddie kind of does. I've heard him use this riff in Girl Gone Bad. Or a variation of that. Also, I think Eruption. Those kind of riffs, right? So I'll show you this. And this one's not as accurately tabbed. I didn't tab it perfectly because I'm just kind of was winging it when I recorded it for this video. But close enough for rock and roll. And hopefully you can get some technical ability out of learning how Eddie is doing these things. So that's a wrap. Hopefully you guys got something out of this and you start using your pinky like good old Alex Van Halen wanted Eddie to. If you'd like to get the tab for this, then click on the link in the description below and hit subscribe, hit the bell so you're notified every time I put up a new video. I will hopefully see you very soon. Keep on practicing those Eddie Van Halen riffs.